calm down before you stress up the groove. The energy a little different when the blessings accrue. Hey, who you talking to? Just know I ain't no regular fool. Could be anything in the world, but I can never be you. Because I
stand tall like I'm on my tiptoes. Baby, you think a little too small. I got big goals, baby. Hey, where the money at? Look, I just need the info. Pronto, I go and get it and split it with my kinfolk daily. And I'm coming in. How you better get out the kitchen? Yeah, I can make a hit on whatever you pitching. Baby, let me fill up whatever you missing. Know you like it up at the top, it's a better view, isn't it? I'm not surprised at all, no way. Hey, what you need, come on, just pay the fee.
Alright, what's up guys, welcome back. Today we got an exciting one. I have my final review of the Nike Pegasus 37 Premium. It really means a lot to me that you're here today, so I'm going to go through a couple specs, some facts about this shoe, and then give you guys my rundown on what I think after 75 miles in this shoe. Sometimes I take my shoes all the way to 100, but for this one, it's just not a whole lot's changed in the last 75 miles, and I feel like I have a really good idea of what this shoe is doing, so we're just going to go for it. So first off, disclosures out of the way, I did pay for this shoe with my own money. No one sent it to me. No one's telling me what to say. These are my honest opinions. So what is the Pegasus 37 Premium? It's basically a Pegasus 37. There's a few updates, and they're very, very small. So the first thing, obviously, is the design. So the placement of the swoosh, like some of the colors, this back band right here is a little bit different. The only real physical difference in this shoe is this tongue right here. From what I can understand, it has got a little bit more padding, but they say it is inspired by Blue Ribbon Sports, which is what Nike was before it became Nike. So to throw a few stats your way, the weight of this shoe in my size 11.5, is 10.87 ounces. And with the stack height, there's a little bit of different information on the internet depending on what website you go to. Actually, Nike.com, and look at the stack height for the Pegasus 37 and the Pegasus 37 Premium. The forefoot is 14 millimeters and the heel is 24 millimeters. But if you go to runningwarehouse.com, it says that the stack height in the forefoot is 23 millimeters and in the heel, 33 millimeters, also giving you a 10 millimeter drop. But there's a pretty big difference in between those two measurements. Running Warehouse says that they measure it with the removable sock liner inside. But the good news is, no matter where you're getting your facts, the drop is still 10 millimeters. And Nike advertises these as everyday responsive training shoes. So they don't really bill them as short distance, middle distance, long distance. They don't say if they're for speed or if they're for easy days. So let's take a tour around the shoe, starting with the upper. It is a lightweight and breathable mesh. In the back, the heel, this little swoop at the end is really nice because it helps protect your Achilles a little bit while still giving you a little bit of extra material back here so that you're not gonna be slipping around and slipping out of the shoe. The tongue is padded and you can see the padding because it's exposed at the top. And you might look at that and say, is that shoe worn out and ripped up? But no, that's just how it was designed. I didn't have any pain from laces or anything like that. Speaking of the laces, they kind of look and feel like kind of just like old school, like just regular laces. They don't ever come undone. Like, I never had any problems with that. There wasn't any like really sharp pressure points along the whole top of my foot. Just actually really good. The only problem is that they're really short. And so even if I wanted to do the runner's loop, I probably couldn't have done it because these laces are just short. The midsole this time around, they went with a full length React midsole. And underneath the forefoot, there is a Zoom air pocket. And Nike has actually pressurized these differently for men and women. The men have 20 PSI and the women have 15 PSI because Nike has determined that that works best. Staying on the bottom of the shoe, the outsole is full length rubber. And on the outside over here, it is a different kind of rubber. It's called BRS 1000 and it actually has carbon in it. So they say it's more durable. Okay, now that we've covered pretty much everything on the shoe, let's start talking about the four things that I like to talk about during my shoe reviews. So number one, fit. Like I said before, I got the size 11.5. It fit true to size. I didn't have any problems at all with the sizing. Didn't have any problems with the fit. The comfort was really good, like right out of the box. Pretty much from the moment I put the shoe on, it just felt like it was perfectly formed to my foot. The heel was locked in and I didn't even need to do the runner's loop. The midfoot is very secure. I was able to get a really good lockdown with the lacing system. The forefoot was just a little bit tight and that's not a complaint at all. Like, it fit really well. It just fit snug. And the React foam was great. I really enjoyed this foam. It's not as soft as some of the shoes I've tried recently. In my experience, the compression of the Zoom Air, it compresses quicker than the React foam. And so for the first like couple miles, it didn't really cause any issues or any problems like that. But after about 7 or 8 miles, it starts to be a little annoying, at least in my experience. I can like definitely clearly feel the cutout. The outside edges, both of my feet, are not compressing as much as this middle portion right here. For that reason, I just wish that the Zoom unit would go all the way across. Now, Nike does have some shoes like that. The Pegasus just isn't one of those. Around the 7 or 8 mile mark, I was starting to just feel it more than I wanted to. It was just starting to cause me a little, we'll just call it sensory grief. All right, but moving on, let's talk about the ride of this shoe. And first, the landing. So this shoe is very much aimed at checking all the boxes for Nike. So the landing kind of has to be tailored to all people and all potential tasks that you throw at it. But all that said, the landing, the React foam, the Zoom unit is a nice experience. Talking about the energy transfer, the 10 millimeter drop mixed with the cut of the outsole and the midsole, it really does get you moving forward. The forward rock isn't anything like super, super special, but the Zoom Air unit in the front is really springy. It did feel better at faster paces. When I was just kind of like slowly moving around, it didn't feel like anything super special. But once I got into the kind of that tempo range, for me, it really felt like I was feeling everything that the shoe wanted me to feel, and it felt like the shoe was actually working for me. Moving on to performance. How does the shoe do in different conditions? Well, I felt like the Pegasus 37 Premium was really responsive. I felt like it did everything I wanted it to do. It never felt like I was really like fighting the shoe. It felt like it was really just like an extension of my foot. No issues with cornering, no issues with bad weather, none at all. The outsole is great in the rain, in the snow, dry. Every condition I ran in it, it was just perfectly fine. And I always want to ask, what's the best distance for a training run or a race? For me, the perfect distance for this shoe is about 7 or 8 miles. I don't know if I would want to run a marathon in this. I think I could probably pretty easily do a half marathon. Like, I didn't have any problems really up to 10 miles. I am, though, really disappointed that I wasn't able to really push the limits of this shoe. My training plan just didn't call for anything longer than 10 miles on the roads over the last like week and a half that I've been testing this shoe. So yeah, really disappointed. I wanted to put a 20 miler on this shoe, but I guess in the grand scheme of things, the most people buying the Pegasus 37 are probably not putting a whole lot of 20 milers on this. As far as the life of the shoe, I think that this could probably last almost as long as you want it to. The outsole on here is showing almost no wear at all. I always have a little tiny bit of wear on the outside once I get close to about 100 miles, and this is not showing anything. But again, this outside edge of this rubber is a little bit stronger. The Nike React foam is barely even showing any creases anywhere. The foam still feels exactly the same as the first day I put this shoe on. And I'm not kidding. Like, that's why I didn't take it to 100 miles before I did this review, because absolutely nothing has changed with what this foam feels like. It feels exactly like the first day I put it on. So I think this shoe will get you to 400 or 500 miles easily, probably longer if you want it to. Especially if you don't have a very aggressive wear pattern on a lot of your shoes. If you're nice to your shoes, you take care of them, I think this one will last a long time. And up next, the appeal of the Pegasus 37 Premium. What do I think of the looks? Well, I think it's awesome. I really like it. It's understated, it's slick, it's kind of like a throwback, especially with the Blue Ribbon Sports logo on the inside of the sock liner. I just really like the looks of the shoe. I think it really communicates confidence. Just looking at the shoe on the shelf, it really makes me want to go run. Like, just the cutout, it just looks like it's actually like moving, even when it's just sitting here. Like right now, I'm just looking at this, I'm like, I want to go for a run. So what's the deal with the Pegasus 37 Premium? Is it worth the price? Well, at $120, I think absolutely yes. This has got full-length React foam, and it feels like it's just gonna last for a long time and probably be worth every dollar. And who's this shoe for? Well, I think it's for anyone that wants a daily trainer that's gonna be reliable, and you're also gonna be benefiting from 37 years of innovation. Like, the first Pegasus came out in 1983, and they've been making a Pegasus version every year since then, and that's just amazing. Unfortunately, this isn't going to be a shoe that's going to compete probably with some of the others that I have for my long 20 miler training days, and it's probably not going to be able to touch the speed of some of the super racer shoes out there, but it's not meant to do either of those things really great. I think it's just meant to do everything pretty well, and that's fine. So there you go. There you have it. That's it. My final review of the Pegasus 37 Premium. Thank you guys for stopping by. Thanks for joining me today. If you like this video, leave a like, leave a comment. YouTube really loves it when you guys are engaging with the video. So thank you again. Thanks for spending your time with me today. If you have an idea for a shoe that you want me to review next, leave it in the comments down below. I've got a stack of boxes over here with shoes in them that need to be run in and reviewed. So subscribe if you want to see those. But that's it, guys. Thank you so much for stopping by. I'll see you again soon. Bye.
Because I stand tall like I'm on my tiptoes, baby. You think a little too small. I got big goals, baby. Hey, where the money at? Yeah, look, I just need the info. Pronto, I go and get it and split it with my kinfolk daily. And I'm coming in. How you better get out the kitchen? Yeah, I could make it.